Some of you young folk who watched the show weren't around to appreciate the classic movie monsters that your grandparents remember oh so well. All right, I wasn't around in the 1930s or 40s either. But odds are, if you ask anyone over the age of 60, they'll remember these names. Boris Karloff, Bela Lugosi, and who could forget Lon Chaney Jr.? Never heard of him, huh? Well, let's take you back to the days of classic cinema with a review of one of my all-time favorite monster movies, The Wolfman. I ask for a wolf sound, and what do I get? This 1941 film stars Lon Chaney Jr. portraying Lawrence Talbot. Talbot is attacked in the woods by what he believes to be an ordinary wolf, but it actually turns out to be Dracula? Yep. For those who are somewhat familiar with classic cinema, that's Bela Lugosi, who played Dracula. In this film, however, he's a traveling fortune teller who becomes a werewolf. And once a werewolf bites a human, they become a werewolf also. So later on, Talbot changes into a werewolf and then stalks the night. And when morning comes, he's a complete mess. Naturally, Talbot is convinced he is a werewolf, but no one believes him. Typical cinema plot, but for the 1940s, it works, folks. Story-wise, I love it. Great interaction between Larry Talbot and the other characters. And Claude Rains plays Talbot's father, and there's a few good scenes with the two of them there as well. If you young ones don't know that name either, try watching The Invisible Man sometime. As with most classic cinema, everything is paced very well. You don't really see the Wolfman appear until 42 minutes into the film. Now, in terms of special effects, even though this was the golden age of film, the transformation from Talbot into the wolf still holds up today as one of the great moments in film history. No CGI can ever reproduce that. I don't care if you people thought the effects in Van Helsing were the greatest thing since sliced bread. And hey, this style of transformation was even used on a more familiar monster. Trying my hardest not to give away the ending, all I can say is the Wolfman did live on to appear in other films, battling Frankenstein, and even in another film, teamed up with Abbott and Costello against Count Dracula. You just can't keep a good wolf, or a bad wolf, down. And I'm glad this Wolfman still lives on in the hearts and minds of classic film buffs and historians. A lot of you haven't seen this film, I know that, so I advise you to see it any way that you can. I promise you a good time.